Good morning, everyone. In today's session, we are supposed to study about feedback amplifier. So, in previous session, we have seen about the operational amplifier. If you see, in our day-to-day life, we are using number of electronic devices. So, we can say there are various branches of electronics like industrial, instrumentation, communication, power electronics. And if you see, all these electronic circuits we are using in applications of these branches like amplifier, timer, various arithmetic circuits, like we can use to do the arithmetic operations, addition, subtractions, multiplier, log, anti-log amplifier. So here we are supposed to see about the op-amp. So we are having one electronic device which can be used to construct all these electronic circuits. Like by using op-amp we can make instrumentation amplifier, by using op-amp we can make industrial electronic circuit. So we can say we are having a one electronic device which can be used to construct all these circuits, and here we are calling that operational amplifier or a op-amp. So when we are using the voltage amplifier, at that time we can make voltage amplifier by using a transistor which will uses many other components, like that can be coupling capacitor, bypass capacitor, the resistor, or we can say the biasing resistor. So in order to get a higher voltage gain, we have to use more than such one op-amp. If we will require higher voltage gain, instead of one op-amp, we can use multiple op-amp together, and this will make the circuit bulky. So here, instead of making that circuit bulky, we can use one simple circuit that we are calling as an integrated circuit. So here, instead of using that bulky circuit in which we are supposed to use transistor, resistor, biasing coupling capacitor, people started using the amplifier in a compact form. That form we are calling as a integrated circuit. So here we are saying we are supposed to use the op-amp. So op-amp is nothing but it is an amplifier which can be configured to perform variety of operations. By using op-amp, we can do amplification, addition, subtractions, differentiation, integration. As we are doing the lots of functions by using a op-amp, we can say that as a operational device. So when we are using the op-amp, we can say it is a basically multi-stage amplifier which will uses a number of amplifier stages that can be interconnected to each other. That can be interconnected to each other in a complicated manner. So in previous session already we have seen about the op-amp, its symbol, how it is looking like, the pin diagram configurations, the characteristics of op-amp, advantages of operational op-amp over a conventional amplifier. So what does mean by the conventional amplifier? If we are making the amplifier by using a transistor, resistor, biasing, coupling, bypass capacitor, at that time you will get the circuit that will be a bulky. That device we are calling as a conventional amplifier. But instead of that, we are supposed to use a simple IC which can be used as a op-amp. So if we will talk about the advantages of op-amp over a conventional amplifier, we can say it will have smaller size. Its cost will be reduced. And as here the number of component we don't require, so we can say less power consumption will be done in a op amp. It is easy to replace because here only we are using one IC. And by using a op amp, we can make number of electronic circuit. Like we can make summing amplifier, subtractor, differentiator, power electronics, any circuit. So here now we can talk about the feedback amplifier. So these are the outlines of our today's session. In today's session, we are supposed to see the general feedback structure as the name defined. And already we have talked about the feedback structure in our second or third unit. I think the second one. Already we have seen when we are giving the feedback from output to the input. At that time, we are calling that as a feedback. When we are giving the feedback from output to the input, at that time we are supposed to see the feedback concept in a operational amplifier, as we have seen about the feedback. If we are using the negative feedback, at that time we are using that feedback in a amplifier, and if we are using the positive feedback, as we have seen in our previous unit, we are calling the device as a oscillator. So here we are supposed to see the some properties of a negative feedback. The four basic feedback topologies we are supposed to see here, like series shunt feedback amplifier, series feedback amplifier, shunt, and the shunt series feedback amplifier. We will see one by one. So here again, after that we are supposed to see the stability problem, stability study using a body plot, the frequency compensation. So here we can see now about the negative feedback concept. So if we will talk about the electronic circuit, we can say it is impossible to think about the electronic circuit without some form of a feedback. So here we are saying we are supposed to use the feedback in a op amp. So here we are using the negative feedback. So we can say when we are using the negative feedback, it will reduces the nonlinear distortion, it will reduces the effect of noise, it will extend the bandwidth of an amplifier. And if we are using the negative feedback, it will control input as well as a output impedance. So the basic idea behind using the negative feedback is nothing but it is a trade-off the gain for other desirable properties of a electronic circuits. So when we are using the positive feedback, we can say there will be a oscillation happens. So we can see here the general feedback structure, how it will be look like a practically. So if we are using the negative feedback structure, at that time we are supposed to give some part of output as a feedback, and that will be given to a input. So we can say here when we are talking about the feedback structure, at that time we can call that as a signal flow diagram, and the quantities x that will represent either there will be a voltage signal or a current signal, any signal if we are using. But here, as we are supposed to use that circuit as a feedback amplifier, we are supposed to give the output that will be given to the input as a negative feedback. So here when we are giving the feedback, at that time you will get there will be a two options, like that loop can be a closed loop or a open loop. So if we are watching this, if you see this diagram, you can see here how it will be look like. Here, when we are giving the feedback X naught to the input, we are giving that to the adder, the summer. So here we can say that is nothing but a closed loop gain. So here we are aware about the gain. How you will calculate that is nothing but that is the ratio of output with respect to a input. Here if we are talking about the voltage, you can take voltage gain. That will be the ratio of output voltage with respect to a input voltage. But here if we can see here, you are saying you will get the feedback factor that we are taking as a beta. So here you will get loop gain that will be equal to A beta, because if you calculate its loop gain, you will get output X naught upon input, that is the source input. So we are taking that as a XS. So you will get the gain of closed loop that will be equal to X naught upon XO upon XS. So we can calculate that as A upon 1 plus A beta. So here we are saying beta is nothing but a feedback factor and loop gain is a A beta. So we can say you will get the amount of feedback that will be equal to a 1 plus A beta. So if we are talking about the negative feedback at that time, you will get here the some properties of the negative feedback. These are nothing but if we are using the negative feedback at that time, you will get reduction in a nonlinear distortion. Their noise will get reduced. Bandwidth will get extended. And if you will calculate its gain desensitivity, you will get DAF upon AF equal to 1 upon 1 plus A beta, because that is a constant, into derivative of A. So DA upon A. Remaining we will see in the next class. Thank you.